This is Chris with TGW, and we are in Carlsbad, California, visiting TaylorMade, and we're with Tom Kroll. Tom, how are you?
I'm great, Chris. How are you?
Good. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, hey, I've been with TaylorMade for 28 years, and I'm so excited to have TGW here on campus to show you a little bit about who we are, what we're all about, and honestly, I think, you couldn't have a better day. It's going to be probably 75 degrees here, so it's a glorious Southern California day, and we're right here on campus. This is our fifth building that TaylorMade has ever had headquarters at. We started back in 1979, all the way back in McHenry, Illinois, moved out to California in 1981, and we've had four other buildings here in Carlsbad and Vista since the beginning. And so 1997, we moved right here to this spot. We're going to go across the street later on and show you our little playground, our sandbox that we hit and try product and show it off to the greatest players in the world. And then in a little bit, we're going to go take a look inside our building and see our production facility and our tour department.
Awesome. Can't wait. Let's get started.
Okay.
So, Tom, tell me a little bit about the wall here.
Well, this, as a company, since 1979 we started, we were really founded by a guy named Gary Adams, this crazy maverick back in McHenry, Illinois, who said, let's make golf clubs out of metal when the whole world was making them out of wood. And I think if you were to think of a real thread that weaves through all those years since 1979 about who TaylorMade is really about its connection to the tour. Number one driver in golf is, honestly, it's a badge that we hang every place we can, and we are going to brag about that because it's a huge accomplishment. We truly connect with the top of the pyramid, and the rest of the golfing world kind of is influenced by this top of the pyramid. We've been the number one driver on tour pretty much for the last 15 years, and every opportunity we have to tell that story and show how we connect with the best players in the world and innovations inspire those guys to play our great products, we're going to take the chance to do it. So that's a list of all of the tour players that we have around the world that give us the ability to claim number one driver in golf.
A lot of names.
Yeah.
All right, Tom, tell me a little bit about this wall.
So this is called the Industry Cup, and as a golf company, we're filled with a lot of competitive golfers and guys that and gals that truly love and appreciate this great game of golf. To say we're competitive would be an understatement, and the Industry Cup is one of those things that that we proudly display here in our lobby. We've been back-to-back-to-back champions of the Industry Cup, so it's a Ryder Cup format. We go up against all of the competition in the golf industry. Great event. Great display of our guys' ability to play the game at a very high level, and something we're really proud of, having the Industry Cup sitting right here in our lobby.
That's awesome. Tom, how long have you been with TaylorMade?
28 years.
Wow, that's fantastic.
Yeah, started a long, long time ago. Came out, I actually started cutting shafts on the production floor, so we'll go out there and take a look at the production floor in a little bit.
So, Tom, what are we looking at here?
Well, this is a history of the metalwood. TaylorMade has been known as an innovator, and honestly, we've innovated since 1979. And the very first metalwood you'll see on the far side, far left of the case here, is the original one, the original TaylorMade metalwood. Golfers, when they first hit it, the golf clubs were made out of wood, and when they first hit this metalwood, it was a very distinctive sound, and honestly, the tour players loved it. It was a performance advantage that the tour players had, and so we exploited that. And honestly, TaylorMade has really evolved from there. You'll see the evolution. It took a while to get to the 2000s. So from 1979, we went from the original one to the Burner Plus, Burner Bubble, which was a historic product for us with the bubble shaft and a whole new technology of tempo and how the golf club swings. The first metalwood to ever win the Masters. In 300 series, the innovations really started to take shape. 500 series, the first inverted cone. Titanium construction, obviously, given us the ability to really define performance for the golfer. R7, the first movable weights, where we were able to manipulate ball flights. So if you have a fade and I've got a drop, we could both play pretty much the same golf club and correct those different ball flights. Evolving into the Burner product, which was honestly a fantastic product for us back in the day when square drivers came out. We came with the Burner driver, and it was absolutely a rocket ship in terms of performance, and it really defined that you know, the technologies that we have and that we employ in metalwood construction and big oversized 460cc club heads truly delivered the performance to the golfer. R9, the first adjustable loft sleeve so you could fit the golf ball through the proper window, and then really iconic in its just the style of it was the R11 with the painting it white, and everybody else was painting them blue and black and dark colors. And you know, it just changed the game forever, and great marketing, great technology with the sole plate, the movable weights, the loft sleeve. Rocket balls really redefined performance in metalwoods and in fairway wood construction. SLDR, again, reinventing movable weight technology and performance for the golfer. R15, and then now to M1, which another reinvention of movable weight technology, carbon construction on the crown. Just absolutely fantastic to see the history and the transition of performance in metalwoods throughout the course of time. And honestly, we couldn't be prouder of the heritage and history that we have here. So it's a pretty cool display.
You know, looking at this, it's kind of funny because I think I've played every single driver from the burner right, which is really funny because
yeah.
You talk about heritage and most golfers, you know, with the presence that you guys have in the wood market, yeah. I think a lot of people can look at this and literally go one by one by one by one saying, I've played all these drivers and they yeah. all were really good. So
yeah, there's great technology in each of these. And honestly, I think the driver is the emotional part of our golf industry where golfers want to hit the ball further. And the driver is truly the product that puts that on display for the golfer. So unless you're hitting it further, you're probably not going to be sniffing for a new driver. And we've had some pretty cool stuff here.
So, Tom, here we are.
Yeah, this is the production floor. And so we're going to make about 1.5 million golf clubs right here on this facility, which is about 25% of the golf clubs for the entire United States. And this is a production floor for us. So right in front of us are what we call a production cell. But the process is really pretty straightforward. Our receiving dock is in the far back left of the building. We'll receive product back in from our vendors, so whether it's heads or shafts or grips or all the components that go into making these golf clubs. They'll go through a really rigorous inspection process, and our vendors learn lessons from us where they need to hit a tolerance. And if their product doesn't meet the specs that we call out, they get it shipped right back to them. So for the first few shipments of product that come to us, these guys are looking at them 100% inspection and seeing if they're falling within the tolerances of what we call out for. If at any point they fail that inspection, they get them all back. So making tomato steaks out of shafts or paperweights out of club heads, they learn a lesson. They don't miss the targets that we have. And then every time we receive product in, we'll inspect them once a vendor's been qualified. You can't inspect quality into a product. If you don't start with good quality, the whole process isn't very good. So it's really important that our guys deliver on that. The production orders will come from up in our operations side of the business, and they'll come down here and tell the production team what they're gonna build. Most of these are custom cells, so you'll see a lot of individual work orders with each of the products. But there's a fully functional production cell right here within probably 30 by 30 square foot area. The shafts will come in, they'll cut the shafts to length, marry them up with the right grips, marry them up with the right heads, and then send them down the line for epoxy, and then they'll put them on a curing carousel. So in about 20 minutes, this entire cell will have cured the epoxy in that club head, come off of there, get gripped. Somebody will inspect the product after it's been gripped, check it for swing weight, check it for all of the characteristics. Each person on the production line is responsible for quality of that product. Once something gets put on, if a head gets put on crooked or a ferrule's not right or a grip is on the wrong way, that person's responsible to make sure they call that out and get the product right or it doesn't leave the building. It'll then go, if it's an iron, it'll leave after it gets gripped and checked for length and checked for all of the build specs. It'll then get sent over to our iron bending machine, which is a bullseye system, and really tight tolerances in terms of bending for loft and lie. So if a golfer wants a 2-degree upright and a degree strong, we're going to give that golf club right to that golfer to the exact specs that they're looking for. So a really cool process for us. Get cleaned up on the back end. So a couple of folks will be able to clean the golf clubs, make sure again they'll do another visual inspection, bag it up,
put it in a box, and then on the far back side of the building is where we're going to ship them out. FedEx trucks are out there waiting for them to get shipped to the customer.
Oh, cool.
And she's going to set the epoxy inside the club head. And then this machine here will set the head, the shaft into the head, set the ferrule in at the proper depth. Clean off any excess epoxy. And then it's really important that we have proper alignment of the shaft and the graphics on the shaft, whether it's metal wood or an iron. So they'll take that graphic, put it in this device here, and make sure that it's completely aligned, and then insert it into the curing cell. So there's a heating element on this carousel, and each club has got epoxy inside of the head. Clamp it down in there, and it'll pass around that curing cell and cure the epoxy so that when they take it off, they can grip it and we can work with the golf club. We're gonna double check for swing weight. And then after he confirms swing weight's correct, a little inspection, make sure everything's good to go. And then we've got a laser that's gonna make sure that the grip and the graphics are all aligned with the score line on the face of the golf club. So we got a perfect golf club. Then it's gonna get handed off to our iron bending machine called the Bullseye. And you'll see the operator will take and he'll target in the specification of what we're looking for and what's been called out on the production order. So whether it's an upright lie angle or flat or strong loft, and that'll calibrate the machine so that it knows what club head is going in there as well as the target for what we're trying to achieve in terms of loft and lie. He'll fixture it up so that there's no damage to the club when it gets captured in there. He'll put the club inside of there. There's a system that's going to measure the shaft and the relation of shaft to club face. So this is where the target is. So once we've got a bullseye set, now he's going to bend this golf club to get into our target. So a bullseye machine determines whether that product is exactly where we want it. And we know we got a golf club that's bent to the exact specification that the customer has ordered. This is our machine shop here. And as you can see, we got a production line with a lot of machines that you can't go down to Home Depot or Lowe's and buy a new iron bending machine. So we've got a fully automated, fully functional machine shop here that builds all of the equipment that we manufacture our products with. So
oh, wow.
Say a laser goes down or one of the parts of our curing cell goes down, we don't want to be out of that machine and out of functionality and production with that machine. So on site, these guys will come, they'll make sure that each one of these machines is, each one of these cells is operating at its capacity, and we can build all of the parts that we need to keep these systems up and running and do it all in-house. So
wow.
It's pretty cool.
That's
yeah.
Really cool.
Yeah. This is the putter lab, and what we will do here is create a lot of prototypes, a lot of the product for our tour players, so they're very specific with things that they want. Maybe they want a different hosel or a machine apart for Justin Rose, or Sergio was just in here a couple of weeks ago. He switched putters, switched his entire style of putter, actually wanted a little bit of a toe up, and so our man Kia Ma, who is one of the absolute finest craftsman in all of golf, was able to, with his team, create a putter for Sergio that had him playing pretty much and putting on form for the last few weeks. So hopefully that carries over and sweeps him right through the Masters. We can get a major out of our boy Sergio this year. But you've got everything that you would need to make a putter, to a fully functional machine shop back here. So a couple of big grinders. We've got a couple of CNC machines in the back corner. Really a high functioning laboratory, really for making precision putters and precision parts for the guys. A lot of times when you've got machines that can mill ahead or mill apart to look or to have a certain style to it, why wouldn't you do that? So they'll take and create rapid prototypes down here and the product creation team will review those designs, do different changes, a little nuance here or there, and kind of find out exactly what the perfect look is, and that'll ultimately become a production part. And then on the other side of that is you've got one-offs where a tour player wants a putter with 3 degrees aloft, and he wants a specific mill on the face, or he wants the sole milled, or he wants a real particular sight line. This is where they would get that product made up for the tour guys. So a lot of cool stuff happens down here. Okay.
So Tom, we're looking at the tour department.
Yeah, you see the Jurassic Park theme here. This is to kind of keep the riffraff out. All the product for the greatest players in the world, pretty much all tours, is going to be made right back through these doors. So we don't have to electrocute anybody to keep them out of there, but it's a pretty cool environment for us to build the best product for the best players in the world.
Yeah,
so let's go take a peek.
Would like to see it.
Oh yeah.
Sure. All right, we're inside with no retina scans yet or thumbprint scans. Let's take a look. What do we got?
So this is our tour department, and you'll see on the back wall every possible head that you could imagine for our tour players is back there on the wall, from metalwoods to irons to all the different grips. You'll see a tour shaft matrix that would just absolutely boggle your mind. So these guys have a lot of different preferences. A lot of different shafts are popular out there. So we've got every opportunity to build that. Similar to the production floor, this is a production facility. It's just on a smaller scale. So instead of a big carousel, each one of the guys who's in our tour department will have a rack that they're working off of. They'll have a production order that's got all the specs of the product that they're going to build. And each guy that's in this department are the best of the best in terms of real club craftsmen. So they're going to build these golf clubs to the spec. If a tour player wants a wedge ground, he wants a little bit of relief in the heel, or straighten up the leading edge, or do some different things, they've got the ability to do that back there. We've got hot melt, we've got swing weight scales, curing cells, you name it, every real function that a production guy would need, a tour technician has at his disposal here, from all of the different weights, all of the different ways to get these golf clubs built up, and really, truly, the best of the best guys that are building these products for these guys, because they're particular. When Justin Rose orders something, he wants it right down to the finest detail. So he gets
them. This is an interesting, because it's small, but in relation to others that I've been to, it's big.
Yeah.
I mean, you can tell that. You guys are manufacturing a lot of clubs for tour out of here.
So this is similar to like a tour truck, just at a much bigger scale. Like you said, it's a bigger operation. The tour guys will call in every week and say, this is what we need to replenish. Cool story, when we were at Torrey Pines, had over 200, it was the first week M2 was available on tour, there was over 200 M2 metalwoods on the tour truck. They ran out on Tuesday. Guys were driving back up to Carlsbad to replenish the coffers there. It was a big field, but the first week that the product was out there, incredible excitement around the M2 driver, M2 fairway woods. So we were humming and buzzing when the West Coast swing was through here, and guys are still getting things dialed in. So it's a really cool operation here.
That's awesome.